Hello and welcome to Arizona Summer Reading Basics and Overview. My name is Donna Throckmorton. I'm a Library Services Consultant with the Arizona State Library. The Arizona Reading Program is sponsored by the Arizona State Library Archives and Public Records, a division of the Secretary of State, with federal funding from the Institute of Museum and Library Services. Historically, summer reading programs strive to keep children reading when they are not in school. We often use them to promote our books, our other library materials, and to encourage reading and learning. Other goals for summer reading program could include bringing in new users or encouraging the use of imagination. A study by the U.S. Department of Education found that 95% of all public libraries offered some form of summer programs. In her book, Running Summer Library Reading Programs, Carol Fior cites research that a positive relationship exists between children who participated in summer reading programs and their gains in reading ability. In these studies, children increased in both vocabulary and comprehension, and they made more improvements than children who did not participate in summer reading programs. So what happens in a typical summer reading program besides mayhem and chaos? The basic components usually include some sort of registration process, participation in events and programs, reading and other types of learning, tracking and measuring success. Every community is unique, and as you reflect on your current summer programs, I would encourage you to think about your desired goals. Each component should contribute to your overall goal for holding a summer library program. When you begin planning, it should begin early. You need to develop a budget, schedule events and programs, order summer supplies through the state library, and order any additional supplies you may need. Plan to keep track of your summer statistics and contact community partners. Here is a suggested timeline in an ideal world. In the fall, begin planning for next year as soon as your summer reading is over. Make sure you schedule performers as early as possible. Sometime between April and May, market your program by visiting schools. And after your summer program is over, report your outcomes to the state library. How do you track participation? Every library is different. Some libraries only track those that come in for their first prize as participating. Other libraries track how many people register online. Other libraries may keep track of how many reading logs or game boards they pass out. I would just encourage you to keep it consistent so that you can compare last year's stats to this year's stats and this year's stats to next year's stats. Many Arizona libraries are participating in an exciting new way to track summer reading. This new approach gives participants a chance to engage with online literacy activities and rewards such as educational games and badges, all while continuing to become better readers. I'm referring to the online software. For libraries outside of Maricopa County, Read Squared is offered to libraries as a year-round reading program solution that enhances the library experience with family accounts, activity logging, badges, suggested reading lists, events, missions, educational activities, opportunities for patrons to enter book reviews, raffles, and more. For libraries in Maricopa County, they have a similar software called Maricopa County Reads. Each year, we should be striving to engage and reach more participants. And by tracking online or other ways, you are learning about what patrons want and how you can reach new library users. So why do we ask you to track reading minutes? The Arizona State Library requests that you report how many reading minutes participants completed throughout the summer. It has been proven to that participation in summer reading program supports reading proficiency, especially if they achieve a habit of reading at least 20 minutes a day. I feel that tracking reading minutes levels the playing field. It provides recognition and rewards efforts and not proficiency. So if you have a slow reader who exerts the same amount of effort of reading for 20 minutes, they are going to receive the same reward as a fast reader who read for 20 minutes. If you use an online software, it sure makes tracking all of those minutes much easier. Here's a sample of a reading log. You may decide to track your reading minutes using a reading log, and perhaps each line or circle could represent 20 minutes. When they come in to earn their first reward, or in this example, a coupon for a local vendor or a business in your town, you can track how many rewards you gave out, and then you would know that your first reward is worth 80 minutes. For very young children who cannot often sit still for 20 minutes at a time, we encourage parents and families to spread reading or other early literacy activities throughout the day. Another component of summer reading programs are the library events. Many participants look forward to your library events each year. The Arizona Performer Showcase is a listing of artists, programs, and performers that are interested in presenting to Arizona library audiences. Library staff can leave feedback on the listed performers to help others narrow down their choices. If you have a favorite performer that is not listed, share this website with them and they can submit their event to be included. For more information about performers, you may want to contact libraries that have hosted them within the past 2 years. These are listed under references. Please exercise due diligence when arranging performers. Other parts that you may want to think about is using staff and volunteers to plan educational and fun activities that focus on the summer reading theme. Some libraries may have simple weekly activities, and others may focus just on a few main events, like an extravagant final event or a big, exciting kickoff event. Don't forget to reach out to community partners such as fire department or the Cooperative Extension Service to help you plan community events that will enrich your library program. So what counts as a summer reading program? Is it the time families, kids, and adults spend in the library? Is it the time family, kids, and adults spend reading? The answer is yes to both. We encourage you to combine reading and learning and library activities to create a positive experience around reading and learning. You can start at the very beginning of the summer, right when school is out, and you can end at the end of summer before school begins. It doesn't need to be confined to the week or two that you may hold programs. Give your library patrons the entire summer to rack up their reading minutes, and make sure you focus on the fun of learning and families reading together. How can you customize your summer reading program to meet the needs of your community? Some communities may have a problem in the summer where kids who usually get their free meals at school no longer have access to food during the summer months. Your library can meet this need. Other libraries find that the online reading program meets a need for those who may be traveling or who live too far away from the library to track their reading minutes. We encourage you to use your summer to provide outreach. Maybe you provide a pop-up story time at the laundromat, the grocery store, or an activity at the park, or become involved in a community fair. Whatever you decide, the length of your summer reading program is up to you. The activities that you decide to plan is up to you. Typically, summer reading programs begin the 1st of June and end July 30th. Make sure to give your library patrons the time they need to really read throughout the summer. There's additional resources for you to help you plan your summer program and make it an amazing experience for your community. The Arizona State Library, make sure you reach out to us and check our website. Don't forget about your friends group. They may be willing to come in and help or provide funding for your summer reading programs. Reach out to local businesses, community organizations, and utilize volunteers such as teens or retirees or teachers who may want to help with the learning that goes on in libraries during the summer. The Collaborative Summer Library Program has a great website with lots of resources. I would encourage you to explore some other perspectives on how to plan a summer reading program and how to make the biggest impact in your community. Here are a few articles that I would recommend. Additionally, ALA has a summer reading program resource guide that you can find online at their ala.org website. You can find other summer reading trainings on our Arizona Libraries YouTube channel, such as marketing your summer reading program, utilizing collaborative summer library program resources, and demonstrating the value of summer reading. Please feel free to reach out to me for additional assistance. I'm here to help. Have a great summer.